right, this channel is not for children, or super duper Christian people, or people without a sense of humor, or people who want to think I'm on drugs. Move around. Well, my power's back on, but a lot of you don't know this, but a year ago in October, which would be 17 months ago, I came home and my downstairs was flooded. It had been that way for probably close to 2 months. So in the heat of the summer, someone left my upstairs unit, both my upstairs units, on 68 degrees, and the drain pan flooded the downstairs. So when I came home, I don't know, around October, I walked in and thought I'd been vandalized. I didn't know what to think, but everything was underwater. I didn't even occur to me insurance would pay for it. And I was telling my boyfriend about it. He said, I called my dad first. He's like, you need to call your insurance company. I said, insurance is gonna, it won't pay for this. He said, yeah, they will. I said, oh. And so I called my insurance company and they said, have someone come out and clean up the damage and we'll pay up to $5,000 to clean it up, dry it up, and to prevent further damage until we can get someone to come out. Because this was like I think I called on Saturday. I got home Friday night and found this mess. I was super upset because my grandfather's clock was like under where the main part that flooded. So anyway, I called and the man came after church Sunday. And he put some more stuff down to keep the water from leaking farther more. And then Monday morning at the crack of dawn, he brought four guys in and they worked in my house all day long. Oh my God, it was like a mess. So, okay, well, they didn't ever pay him. So I had to pay him myself. And it took forever to get, an adjuster. A guy came out, looked at the damage, and it was going on, I want to say, well into November, and the guy still said he had not made a decision whether or not the claim was going to be covered by homeowners. I said, well, okay, well, why wouldn't it be? And he said, well, there's been a lot of tornadoes in Dallas, and I'm really busy, and I don't, basically saying he didn't have time to deal with my house. And I said, okay, so when do you think you're going to make a decision on whether or not the claim is going to be covered by homeowners? You know, I need to know. So anyway, he was super condescending and basically rude to me. And so he finally did send me something in the mail, I want to say around December, it'd been a while. And my deductible was $4,700 because I live where there's hurricanes, so homeowners is super expensive. And so if you go with higher deductibles, you don't have to pay as much. I'm still paying about $300 a month. And I don't have the house insured at what I should have it insured. It should have about $350,000. But I have less than $200,000 because I live in an expensive resort area, and with homeowners association dues, property taxes, homeowners insurance, not counting what it costs for water. Water is $90 a month out there. It costs me about $900 a month for that house to sit there paid for. For it to be paid for and sit there, that's how much it costs me. So no, I can't afford $500 or $600 a month for homeowners. So this guy, Luke, his name was, with Wellington Insurance, which is some company that Allstate represents, he acted like I lived in a shack. He made me feel ashamed of my house, which I love my house. I bought this house in 1999. But when he sent me the bid, it was for $6,600 and I had a $4,700 deductible. And I'd already paid that one man right at close to $5,000 for cleanup. And then he left some big industrial fans and some, I guess, moisture things to try to keep it from molding because it was, you know, underwater and set that way for a long time. Anyway, so I had to pay for all that too. So the insurance company, they wouldn't ever pay him. He waited and waited. So I had to pay him. I paid the air conditioner. It was the drain pan on the unit in the upstairs right in front of the three bedrooms. It was that unit. The drain pan overflowed because someone left both units on 68 degrees. Who did this? I don't know. But I have grown children and the lady that lives in my rent house, she can come into my house. I don't know who in the world left it at 68 degrees. I don't know. It's my cleaning lady. I really have no idea. But the whole point is the drain pan overflowed, which is what flooded and caused all the damage downstairs. I thought the floor was going to be gone. But anyway, so he came up with $6,600 worth of damage, $4,700 deductible. He depreciated a lot, I think around close to $1,000. Sent me a check for, I think, $800, and that was it. So it happened, that was around Christmas time. Okay, it sent me into a depression, it did, because my house, like birds can fly into my house. A bird was dead on the second floor when I went back home, and a bird was dead on the third floor because you actually, over the front door, after they got through cleaning up all the damage and stuff, there's actual holes over the front door where birds can come in. As a matter of fact, today when I went out to see if the power was on, there was a bird flying around on the second floor. So, okay, so my house has been this way. I finally talked to my agent and told him how that Luke guy was. My agent called the Luke guy with Wellington, and he said the guy was condescending toward him as well. Well, he had met the vice president of Wellington Insurance at a meeting, and he called that man, and that man called me, and they gave us a 6-month extension because of the COVID, because you couldn't get anyone to come out and give you estimates because everyone was so scared of coronavirus, because this happened in October. I didn't get the thing from the guy till December, and in January, you know, coronavirus started. By February, we were getting close to lockdown. So the whole point is everything was shut down. So the vice president gave us a 6-month extension and gave me over to a guy named Michael because Luke was no longer with Wellington. I hope you were fired, Luke. So the Michael guy seemed really cool. Hopefully he is. They wanted an estimate. I sent an estimate, and he freaked out and started yelling at me and said that basically it was like me going to the grocery store and saying a pound of hamburger meat cost $30. Because the estimate was for $14,750. I live in a resort. No one works for free. They think we're rich. I'm not rich, but I'm just saying, if you're gonna have something done in Rayburn Country, you're gonna pay for it. I had an awning built over my upstairs bedroom window, you can see right now, and it was $1,000 just to have an awning built. That's just an example. I'm just saying, no one's going to do anything for $6,600. So he finally sent me a check for repair for my grandfather clock, which the repair estimate was $850. He mailed me $750. He has yet to mail me the $3,850 for the cleanup because I had to have another estimate written out because Sugar Limbrick, he didn't make it detailed enough. The other guy, they gave the $14,000. It wasn't detailed enough, and it didn't count flooring. So I've sent a flooring estimate of around $8,000. That's the flooring and removing the floor that was underwater. And let's see, I've got to get a sheetrock estimate. So we're going to have another guy come out and reassess the damage. They've given me a 2-month extension. I am going to send this to Michael Massey at Wellington Insurance, which must not be a great company. I really don't know. But my agent is aggravated at him too. He is an Allstate agency. Anyway, that's what's going on, and that's why I'm going to post this video. And I'm hoping that Michael Massey and I can work together and get this fixed. I had a contractor I met during the snowstorm whose sister's second in charge for the Board of Texas Insurance, but he said they're bullying you. And I do feel like I've been bullied. I feel like they don't want to pay. And I'm paying them $300 a month, and have been for a couple years, and they've sent me $800 and now $750 for my clock, and that's it. And it's been this long. So, and I'm just saying, like, I hope this all works out. I hope I can come back and tell y'all Wellington Insurance paid off. But so far, like, when I was a young single mom, I was with the Texas Fair Share Plan. And that's for people who don't have good credit or don't have a lot of money or something. And they paid excellent during a hurricane. Now I'm with a real company and they won't even pay me. So I'm just saying, he actually screamed at me about hamburger meat and the cost of it. He's apologized numerous times. I forgive you, Michael Massey. I'm just saying, can we please work together? Can we get my home fixed? Because April is going to be the end of my 6-month extension, April 5th. My home hasn't been fixed yet. You've given me another 2-month extension, but people in Rayburn, they have their pick of work. You have to wait in line to have someone come work for you. The man that came today, he laughed about the $6,600. He said there's 3 different things that have to be done: flooring, the walls, and then painting and sheetrock and all that stuff. That there's 3 different things that have to be done. That there's every one of them are over $6,000. So anyway, that's what's going on with me and my house. So everybody, please send out positive vibes that Michael Massey with Wellington Insurance will send me out some money, please. Over and out, P-Baby loves. Mwah. This song reminds me of myself. Over and out. Hey, baby loves. And if anybody else is getting screwed over by their homeowners, share this. Share it on social media. And it's an Allstate company. Allstate sold it to me. Wellington Financial, Wellington Insurance. Yeah, they're not wanting to pay. It's been 1 year and 5 months and nothing's been done yet. So there you go. Pass it on. Leave a comment if you've been screwed over by your homeowners insurance.